Hello. So this is a short video about how Stalin came to be leader of the Soviet Union after Lenin's death in 1924. So I'm just going to cover the period from 1924 up until 1928, which was the year by which Stalin had really kind of established his authority over the party and over the country. The big issues that were facing the Soviet Union at the time of Lenin's death were what to do about the new economic policy. And indeed, the sort of wider question there was how to modernize the country, because the country was still essentially quite a backwards, quite an undeveloped, and a largely agricultural country. And another big question was, well, what to do about communism generally and about sort of revolution generally? Should the Soviet Union seek to export communism around the world, or should it just concentrate on building communism in Russia, just in their own country? The key players in the Communist Party in 1924, at the time of Lenin's death, was of course Stalin, who by 1924 was the general secretary of the Communist Party, an incredibly powerful position that gave him huge powers over recruitment to the party, and of placing people in certain positions. Was a key sort of organizational post for him to have. Trotsky, who was still the Commissar for War, had led the Red Army to victory in the Civil War of 1918 to 21, had been Lenin's right-hand man during the revolution, and so was still a revered person within the Communist Party. And two other guys, Zinoviev and Kamenev, Gregory Zinoviev and Lev Kamenev. Zinoviev was chairman of the Soviet in Leningrad, which was the new name for the city of what first was St. Petersburg and then became Petrograd. And Kamenev was chairman of the Soviet in Moscow, which be had become the capital in 1918. Now, initially, in 1924, at the time of Lenin's death, Zinoviev, Kamenev, and Stalin joined up in a so-called triumvirate, a group of three, against Trotsky. They were all suspicious of Trotsky. None of them particularly liked Trotsky. They all found him a little vain, a little arrogant. They were also suspicious of him because he'd only joined the Bolsheviks at the last moment in 1917. Of course, he'd been a Menshevik up until then. And Trotsky didn't even bother to attend Lenin's funeral in 1924, which was a ridiculous mistake for him, by him. It enabled Stalin to give the main speech, give the main oration at Lenin's funeral, and therefore kind of present himself as the natural heir to Lenin. So that was a silly mistake for Trotsky to make. Especially as his position as Commissar for War, kind of like the Minister for War, was an important one, but not so important now the Civil War was over. And it also didn't really give him a strong base within the Communist Party. It gave him a position within the government, and he was still a member of the Politburo, which was kind of like the cabinet. And he was still a member of the Central Committee, which was an important position within the party, but he didn't have as strong a base within the party as Kamenev, Zinoviev, and Stalin. Anyway, what happened? The process by which, between 1924 and 1928, that Stalin managed to kind of outflank his rivals is quite a complicated one and involves quite a lot of twists and turns. But briefly, the details are this: that in 1925, Trotsky was relieved of his job as Commissar of War because he disagreed with Stalin, Trotsky, and Kamenev over whether the Soviet Union should seek to export revolution around the world or whether they should concentrate on building socialism in one country. Trotsky very much wanted to continue revolution around the world, thought that the Soviet Union wouldn't survive if it was just the only communist country in the world and that it was surrounded by hostile capitalist powers. So he wanted to continue revolution around the world. Stalin and Trotsky and Kamenev thought that they should concentrate on building socialism in one country. And so there was a big disagreement between them over that. They also disagreed about the NEP. Trotsky favored getting rid of it and moving towards rapid industrialization. Stalin played his cards close to his chest on that issue, but Zinoviev and Kamenev felt that the country should continue with the NEP. And Trotsky also made some criticisms of Stalin about the party becoming too bureaucratic, which was kind of a veiled attack on Stalin because he was the general secretary of the party. Anyway, all of these disagreements between those four players led to Stalin, Kamenev, and Zinoviev outvoting Trotsky and having him removed from his post as Commissar for War in 1925. However, the following year, in 1926, Kamenev and Zinoviev started to change their mind about the new economic policy and about socialism in one country, and find themselves drifting towards the ideas of Trotsky, and formed a so-called united opposition against the ideas of Stalin. Kamenev and Zinoviev by 1926 had become suspicious of Stalin and what his ultimate objectives were. So Stalin teamed up with some other members of the Politburo, Rykov, Tomsky, and principally Nikolai Bukharin, who was seen as the leading theoretician, the leading economist within the party. These three were known as the right opposition within the party. Stalin teamed up with them to outvote Trotsky, Zinoviev, and Kamenev over the issues of what to do about the NEP. So Stalin sided with the right opposition of Tomsky, Rykov, and Bukharin to argue that the NEP should be continued with. And they managed to win that vote in the party congress. And of course, Stalin's position as chairman of the Bolshevik Party is crucial in enabling him to win these votes over policy. After that vote in 1926, Trotsky was expelled from the Politburo and the Central Committee, and Zinoviev and Kamenev were sacked. So Stalin had managed to get rid of some his principal opponents there by 1926. And in fact, in 1927, Trotsky was expelled from the party altogether and sent into internal exile. 2 years later, he was sent into external exile. He was kicked out of the country, which is pretty incredible, really, that 10 years after the Bolshevik Revolution in 1917, one of the principal architects of that revolution had been kicked out of the party, sent into internal exile, and then another 2 years later sent into external exile. In 1928, Stalin then turned against the so-called right opposition of Bukharin, Rykov, and Tomsky to argue that the NEP wasn't delivering in terms of modernizing the country, that it wasn't building a socialist country, and that it was now time to adopt the policies that the left opposition had previously advocated of rapid industrialization and collectivization of agriculture. Now, of course, lots of people in the party thought, what's Stalin doing here? He's just stealing the policies of the people that he's expelled from the party earlier. But because there was such loyalty within the party to Stalin, because he was the general secretary of it, he was able to do that and to outvote the so-called right opposition. When he'd done that, and he'd managed to get Bukharin and Rykov and Tomsky demoted or sacked, he was then in sole charge of the party. And he then set about at the end of 1928 and into 1929, what historians call the Great Turn. That's embarking on this new program of industrialization and collectivization. And they'll be the subject of the next film.